So then this last hadith, which to me is one of the most important hadiths, عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من حسن إسلام المرء تركه ما لا يعنيه. This hadith is a hadith that Imam al-Tirmidhi relates, and Imam al-Tirmidhi رضي الله عنه أبو عيسى al-Tirmidhi was from Tirmidh, which is in Central Asia, or it's also Tarmadh with a fatha and Turmudh. So there's like a different ways of pronouncing it. Apparently they pronounce with a fatha traditionally. It was Tirmidhi. Yeah. But he's known as Imam al-Tirmidhi with a kasra. Another one of the great, he was a student of Imam al-Bukhari. So he had a photographic memory. And he could just hear it one time, and it was with him. And these were people, Allah hayya'ahum, he prepared them to carry this religion. But this hadith is a very foundational hadith. Abu Huraira relates it, and Ibn Abi Zayd said it was, Imam Ahmad and Ibn Abi Zayd put it in their choice of the most important hadith. This hadith, almost all of the problems on this planet come from this problem of being concerned with what's of no concern to you. Minding your own business. It's such a difficult thing for human beings to do. Everybody wants to put their nose in other people's business. Ahmad Sarruq said, the door of peril, of destruction, is opened by saying, how so-and-so? It's like, yiftahu bab al-halak, you know, like, just how so-and-so? Because why are you asking how so-and-so? Because very often people ask hoping something's wrong with so-and-so. You know, it's a very common thing that people do. So, and then why are people obsessed with, why is there a whole section on the news feed on the royal family? Like, well, what is that? You know, and then all the clickbait. So Al-Hakim Samarqandi, who was one of the students of Imam al-Maturidi, Abu Mansur al-Maturidi, the great mutakallim, Imam al-Ghazali said that he said, كل الفتن تنشأ عن ثلاث. All of the calamities in this dunya are for three reasons. طالب الأخبار, ناقل الأخبار, ومتلقي الأخبار. People seeking news, so we would call those news hounds, news junkies. People spreading news, so we'd call those newscasters. And متلقي الأخبار, people receiving news. And he said, وَلَا يَخْلُصُ أَحَدُهُمْ عَنِ الْمَلَامَةِ. None of them are free of the blame. And this is what this is about. You know, it's like, أَقْبِلْ عَلَى شَأْنِكَ. Concern yourself with yourself. But if you get outside of that into these other areas, you're going to be complicit in crimes unimaginable. And people don't think about this. They don't think about the ethical reality of just being alive here, you know. I mean, I have a son, I don't know where he got this from, but he will not buy anything that's not made locally or in the, and it's very interesting because we don't think about that. Like, we get these cheap clothes. CNN had a report where the average American has 50 slaves working for them around the world, just to supply our lifestyles, right? So you're wearing clothes that were manufactured in sweatshops, but they're cheap. You know, there was a documentary called The High Cost of Low Prices. People don't think about that, of buying local, of small scale businesses, because all these corporations, you know, they'll go where it's cheapest, where they can exploit the workers, where there's no labor laws. That's what they do. Labor is really important. Work is important. And one of the problems with our lifestyles is that everybody wants to live. We'd need, for the world to live like the average American lives, you'd need three Earths to provide the resources for it. It's unsustainable. So this hadith is such an important hadith, just to really preoccupy yourself with what concerns you. You know, to work on yourself, to not worry about other people. أقبل على شأنك. And that's why, that was Imam Malik, when Imam Shafi asked him how old he was. Because that's a curiosity for people. I wonder how old he is. And he just said, أقبل على شأنك, mind your own business. Which might seem harsh, but it was a great lesson to him, because he would say that whenever anybody asked him how old he was. So he got the point. And Malik said, if you tell somebody your age, they'll either say, oh, I thought you were younger than that, or oh, I thought you were older than that. Like, it's never work out. Yeah, apparently the Hunzas like add like 20 years to their age or something. That's why, you know, they said the Hunzas are the oldest living people, but they get to a certain age, they just add like a decade or something. So when they're like 80, they say they're 90 and say, yo, you look great. So, min husni Islam al-mar'i, from the beautiful Islam of a person, is that they leave what does not concern them. Ya'ni is one of the most beautiful words in the Arabic language. It's really one of my favorite words. Arabs love it so much, they say it all the time. Ya'ni, ya'ni, ya'ni. Right? It's like you know in English. People that say you know. But aniya ya'na and ana ya'ni, it has to, one of the meanings is to suffer. You know, so mu'anat is suffering. So yu'ani from something is to suffer, right? But it's also, if you actually looked at it, it's a muhawala form, yuhawilu, it's to attempt something. So it's to attempt to find meaning. So suffering in Arabic, if you just look at the word linguistically, at what it actually means, it means an attempt to find meaning. That's what mu'anat means in Arabic. Yu'ani, he's trying to find ma'na. That's what suffering is. It's to bring you back into reality. And من ظن انفكاك لطفه عن قدر من ظن انفكاك لطفه عن قدره فإنه من قصر نظره والذي واجهتك منه الأقدار هو الذي عودك حسن الاختيار. I mean, Faqir Banani said, if you could recite in other than the Quran, I mean, it's hyperbole, but he said it would be with the hikam of Ibn Atayla. It's like wahi. It's so amazing. But he said, whoever thinks that the lutf of Allah, the care of God, the grace of God is absent in the qadr of God, in the decree of God, it's from myopia. It's from your own short-sightedness. And then he says, because the one who has brought these tribulations upon you is the same one that accustomed you to blessings. In other words, the only reason you know the tribulations is because you were accustomed to the husn al-ikhtiyar. It's so beautiful. So when things go south, the reason that you're aware of that is because they were up north before. That's a very geocentric, Eurocentric view. You know, the Muslims put the map, and I wanted to do a Muslim map for our children's classrooms called the restorative map, you know, which puts the south on the top. Because all the Muslim maps were made with the Africa was on the top and Europe was on the bottom. And they switched it around, which is psychological, right? But like the poet said, you'll find out when you reach the top, you're on the bottom. La ilaha illallah. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر اللهم تقبل منا صيامنا وقيامنا وركوعنا وسجودنا اللهم إن شاء الله تقبل منا هذه الأيام الأخيرة جعلنا من عتقاء هذا الشهر يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم اجعلنا من الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسن اللهم اجعلنا من الذين يطبقون سنة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم أريني نبينا يا الله أرينا نبينا في المنامات يا الله اللهم متعنا برؤياه يا رحم الراحمين وصل اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلم على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين.